Hi and assalamu alaikum to everyone. My name is Wan Marisa Sarafina binti Wan Abdul Jalil and I'm from AS251. Today I will talk about how we can drink enough water. Have you ever asked to yourself how much water should we take per day? It is a simple question but with no easy answer. Studies have provide varying recommendations over the years, but your individual water needs depend on many factors, including your health, how active you are, and where you live. Water is your body's principal chemical component and makes up about 50% to 70% of your body weight. Your body depends on water to survive. Every cell, tissue and organ in your body needs water to work properly. For example, water will get rid of wasted through urination, perspiration and bowel movements. Keeps your temperature normal. And then it will protect sensitive tissues. If we have lack of water, it can lead to dehydration. Dehydration is a condition that occurs when you don't have enough water in your body to carry out normal functions. Even mild dehydration can drain your energy and make you feel tired. So, how much water do you need? Every day you lose water through your breath, perspiration, urine and bowel movement. For your body to function properly, you must replenish its water supply by consuming beverages and foods that contain water. So, how much fluid does the average health adult in a temperature climate? The United States National Academies of Science, Engineering and Medicine determine that the adequate daily fluid intake is about 15.5 cups means 3.7 liters of fluids a day for a man and about 11.5 cups which means 2.7 liters of fluids a day for a woman. These recommendations cover fluids from water, other beverages and food. About 20% of daily fluid intake usually comes from food and the rest from drinks. In this slide, I will talk about the purpose of drinking water. Kaiser Permanente nephrologist Stephen Guest says that fluid loss occurs continuously from skin evaporation, breathing, urine and stool, and these losses must be replaced daily for good health, he says. When your water intake does not equal your output, you can become dehydrated. Fluid losses are accentuated in warmer climates, during strenuous and exercise, in high altitudes, and in older adults whose sense of thirst may not be as sharp. Firstly, drinking water helps maintain the balance of body fluids. Your body is composed of about 60% of water. The functions of this body fluids include digestion, absorption, circulation, creation of saliva, transportation of nutrients, and maintenance of body temperature. When you are in a low on fluids, the brain triggers the body thirst mechanism. And unless you are taking medication that make you thirsty, Guest says, you should listen to those cues and get yourself a drink of water, such as juice, milk, coffee, anything but alcohol. Next, water can help control calories. For years, dietitians have been drinking lots of water as a weight loss strategy. While water doesn't have any magical effect on weight loss, substituting it for higher calorie beverages can certainly help. Food with high water content tends to look larger, its higher volume requires more chewing, and it absorbed more slowly by the body, which helps you feel full. Water-rich foods include fruits, vegetables, broth-based soups, oatmeal and beans. And lastly, water helps us to keep skin looking good. Your skin contains plenty of water and functions as protective barrier to prevent excess fluid loss. Okay, we can look at the other side of me. We can see there's a poster about consequence of dehydration. There are about thirst, skin, kidneys, physical, mental, dehydration, weight loss, and water. For physical, studies have shown that the modest level of dehydration, 2% of body mass, can result in around a 20% decrease in physical performance level in temperature climates and up to 40% decrease in hot temperatures. Here's a 4 sign that indicate you may need to start drinking more water to benefit from improved health. Firstly is poor skin health. Water dehydrates and plumps skin cells to make your skin look brighter, vibrant, and more youthful. However, lack of water can cause skin to lose its plumpness and elasticity. It will lead to dryness, flakiness, fine lines, wrinkles, and sagging skin. Water even helps reduce acne and other skin problems by flushing harmful toxins from the body. If beauty products and skin treatments are failing to improve the appearance of your skin, drink more water to achieve a more youthful appearance and to reduce and improve skin problems. Secondly, dehydration interferes with the body's ability to reach into glucose stores for energy and can trigger cravings for foods high in sugar and carbohydrates. Unusual and sudden cravings for sugary foods like chocolates, donuts, cookies, and candies may indicate that your body is in great need of water. If you are experiencing sugar cravings or hunger pangs even though you are recently eaten, try drinking more water to rehydrate your body and keep cravings at bay. Moreover, when your body is hydrated, the kidneys retain as much fluid as possible to maintain their function. This can lead to decreased urination, means one of the most common signs of low water intake. Lack of water can cause your urine to become more darker, stronger in odor, or cloudier in appearance. You may also face a high risk of urinary tract infection when your body lacks enough water to flush our toxins and bacteria out. You will know you are drinking enough water when you start urinating more frequently and the urine is clear, lighter in color, and far less odorous. Last but not least is persistent bad breath. Water is essential for saliva production and help rinse away bacteria so you can maintain healthy teeth and gums. Lack of water inhibits saliva production and causes bacteria to build up on the tongue, teeth, and gums. Lack of water inhibits saliva production and causes bacteria to build up on the tongue, teeth, and gums, and contributing the bad breath. If you practice good oral hygiene, yet continuing suffering from chronic bad breath, it's possible you may not be drinking enough water. Make an appointment with your doctor if bad breath persists after increasing your water intake to rule out other underlying causes such as a gum disease, type 2 diabetes, and liver or kidney problems. With that, thank you.